Hi, welcome to our new tutorial. Today we are going to discuss about few more examples of dicotyledonous seeds. We have studied about a basic seed plan and morphology of pea as dicotyledonous exalbuminous seed in our previous class. If you have not watched it yet, please check it out. The I button up here denotes the link. Let's learn. Cotyledonous exalbuminous seed, that is seeds with two cotyledons or seed leaf. There is no presence of endosperm, the nutritive tissue. We have studied about pea, which is the common example of dicotyledonous exalbuminous seed. Today we are going to learn about few more common seeds in this category. In gram, the seed is broad at one end and somewhat pointed at the other. On the seed coat, below the hilum, there is another more prominent scar, the strophiole, which is a scar left by a funicular outgrowth. The brown seed coat is the testa, but on its inner side, a papery white membranous layer may be distinguished as the tegmen. The embryo does not differ from that of pea except in shape. There are various types of beans, of which Dolichos lablab is very common. The seeds occur in the pod as in peas. They are larger and more or less oval. The seed coat, mainly the testa with a thin fused tegmen, is very hard and colors are in this case a dark green. The funicle is extended into a long raphe, which is seen above the hilum. The embryo is as usual. There are quite a few other dicotyledonous exalbuminous seeds that we commonly come across. The tamarind seeds is rectangular and covered by a very hard shell like seed coat. The hard covering on the seed of mango is actually the innermost layer of the fruit, which is not a part of the seed. Inside, the two very large cotyledons are covered by a papery seed. In jackfruit, the two cotyledons are of irregular and unequal size. The seed coat shows both testa and tegmen. The cotyledons contain latex and of course lot of starch. In the cucurbits, gourd, cucumber, etc. of cucurbitaceae, the seed is rather flat. The testa is horny and free from the thin tegmen inside. The cotyledons also are flat, although they contain a very good amount of food matter, including oil. They show vein marking, although white. The sunflower seed is actually its fruit enclosing a single seed. The hard covering in the fruit wall or the pericarp. Inside, the oily embryo is found covered by a brownish membranous seed coat. Mustard, groundnut, sesame and flaxseed contain lot of oils in their cotyledons. In orange and lemon, the seed is sometimes polyembryonic, that is, it contains more than one embryo. The oak acorn is a fruit. The testa of the pomegranate is juicy and forms the edible part. In this type of seeds, the food is not stored in the two cotyledons of the embryo, but in the endosperm external to the embryo. It will be seen later that all embryos get their food from the endosperm, which in its turn gets its food from the nucellus of the ovule. In the exalbuminous type of seeds, the embryo completely consumes the endosperm and nucellus so that they are no longer seen while the food is kept stored in the cotyledons, which become swollen. In the albuminous type, the endosperm is still present and the cotyledons are thin, acting only as food sucking organs. A very common example is the castor bean, where the fruit is not a bean but a three-chambered capsule. Here, the seed coat is very hard shell of a mottled black or brown color. The hilum is almost hidden by an outgrowth, the caruncle. The caruncle is spongy and absorbs water readily so that it may be of some use in germination. There is a distinct raphe running longitudinally down the seed from the hilum. This membrane is sometimes supposed to be the tegmen but has been found not to be a part of the seed coat. It is a remnant of the nucellus which has not been completely used up. Such a remnant is called the perisperm. Inside the membrane, the whole whitish, fleshy, slightly flattened and oval mass is the endosperm, which contains much oil. On cutting open the endosperm, the embryo is found to remain embedded inside. There are two thin white cotyledons. The cotyledons show distinct vein markings like leaves. The veins leave an impression on the endosperm. The two cotyledons are hinged to the tegmen, which shows the protruding radicle, which is a short hypocotyl behind it, and the plumule hidden between the cotyledon. Among common plants, the dicotyledonous albuminous type of seed is also found in papaya, jute, cotton, mirabilis. Some whole families show this type of seed, like Magnoliaceae, Anonaceae. The family Nymphaeaceae shows perisperm and aril in addition to the endosperm. In the water lily of this family, the testa and tegmen surround a mass which is the perisperm. Inside it, on the pointed end, is the minute embryo embedded in a small endosperm. The raphe is prominent. The seed has a third covering called the aril, which is a spongy and helps the seed to float. The family Papery shows both endosperm and perisperm. The common black pepper of this family is a fruit with a single seed, endosperm, and a tiny embryo. In coffee, the small embryo with two cotyledons is embedded in a mass of horny endosperm formed mostly of hemicellulose. In few common examples of dicotyledonous and polycotyledonous seeds with presence of nutritive tissue or not, this is the book I have followed, and I thoroughly read about this book. The morphology chapter is quite understandable. You should try this book. In our upcoming class, I will discuss about monocots. That's it for today's tutorial. Thank you for your patience. If you like the video, hit the like button below. Do not forget to share, subscribe, and comment.